A new flick about my favorite sport with the details, the very tan Kathy Kastner.
Thanks, Ann. Well, I have to admit I'm not a sports fan. It's probably because I don't understand what's happening. However, I do like Neil Simon, and his latest movie is all about baseball. It's called The Slugger's Wife. Here's John Burgess.
The cry of play ball will not resound through Exhibition Park until April 16. But you don't have to wait until then to get your nine-inning fix, because this Friday, The Slugger's Wife comes to local movie screens. Real ball players are in the film, including 1976 Rookie of the Year, Mark the Bird Fidrich. We talked about real ball versus movie ball games.
It was different in the aspect of it wasn't a real game. You know, see, we had to play act the game and set up, you know, like a hit and run situations, you know, or the double play situation, where in normal game you're playing the game and you're so used to playing the game. Now you had to go through the stuff that you normally used to do playing ball, and really there's not much there to motivate you, because it's not like if this guy gets a hit, you're going to lose the game. But then you had to start imagining that all of a sudden, you know, then you got into the role of, you know, this and that, and then it started falling in, and they started getting into it.
Lisa Langlois plays a rock singer who gets involved with ball player Michael O'Keefe.
You always wear that perfume?
As long as I can remember. Is it all right?
It's great. I just wonder where I might have smelled it before.
Oh, everywhere in Atlanta, probably. It's really popular.
Lisa Langlois, you've had a busy career, some great films, some not-so-great films. Is The Slugger's Wife going to be a breakthrough for you?
Yeah, on two levels, because it restored my faith in myself, in my career, and it restored my faith in the industry, because, as you know, I've done the full circle now. I've been in French films, French artistic films, I've been in Canadian tax shelter films, I've been in American flops, I've been in an American hit, and so now I know what I want to do.
Neil Simon wrote the screenplay for this movie. He was on the set when it was being made. Did he interfere a lot? What was his role?
Actually, I felt it was a luxury to have him around on the set, because normally there's no writer on the set. So if a question comes up, people invent things. The director invents things, the actors invent things, and so you bastardize the script. And so it was a real luxury having him there. Of course, I was quite intimidated at first, because there's not an acting class in the world that doesn't teach Neil Simon plays.
You do quite a bit of singing in this film. Have you considered a stage career as a singer as opposed to being in movies?
Acting's my first love, but I could handle a singing career as a lover on the side.
The Slugger's Wife opens Friday in Toronto.
Love potion number 9.